Hi guys, this is another Christmas special. It's Christmas Cheer, Kasugi Bakko X Listener. And written by Milo, It's Not Gay, on Wattpad, link in the description below. No further ado, let's begin. Just give me a second, there. It was no secret that Bakko hated Christmas. He made it very clear that he disliked the holiday. And he also made sure that every single one of his classmates felt as miserable as he did. But there was one in particular that he found difficult to break. When Ellen, the hair color girl, was just too happy, her loving the winter season made it almost impossible to make her upset. Nor could bring down her spirit, Larry Venkatsky, and that pissed him off to no end. Snowball fight! Wayne yelled. She scooped up a handful of snow and shaped it into a sphere. Bakko turned around. Izuku turned around to see what all the commotion was about, only to be hit in the face by a snowball, sending him falling backwards into the snow. Denki was laughing and chuckling, one in Wayne's direction, hitting her shoulder. Throughout the battle, the girl convinced more of her classmates to join their little game. She managed to get Hiroshima, Redaka, and even Todoroki to participate. Bakko watched from afar, eyes burning with hatred. Attempt 78. Operation ruined this stupid bitch snowball fight. He thought to himself. The ashfall slowly made its way over to the group, hand stuffed in his pockets. Was left to feel the cold air as she tossed an ice ball towards Ejiro. The raider dodged an attack, and the attack fell on none other than Katsuki Bakko himself. Sorry. Specifically, his face. A few gasps and murmurs ran through the small crowd. Wayne hurried forward and stopped in front of Katsuki. Oh my, I'm so sorry. Are you alright? Did I? An explosion went off, cutting her sentence short. The color girl lifted her arms, shielding her eyes from the spreading ash. When the smoke cleared, they found themselves standing in a patch of dead grass and mud, not a single speck of snow left in the ground. Whoops! Katsuki smirked. Looks like you're out of snow. Wayne stared at the ground with her brows pulled together. For a moment, Bakko thought she looked angry, which only made him smirk, grow more turpent. But then she looked up with a bright smile on her face. That's fine. We'll just go get some hot chocolate. His smirk morphed into a scowl as he watched Wayne gather her friends and led them to a nearby coffee shop. Damn it! He cursed and kicked the ground below his feet. Woo! Wayne laughed as she flew down the hill atop her sled. Izuku was seated behind her, arms around her waist, and the eyes grew in fear. Too fast, too fast, too fast! The greener boy squealed, causing Wayne to giggle. Kasuki stood at the bottom of the hill, leaning back against a tree, with an annoyed expression adorning his face. Okay, this is it. Make her crash her sled. Maybe I'll get a lucky and she'll break every bone in her body. How is it with Christmas cheer if she can't move? The sound of the sled scraping across the snow met Bakko's ears, and he smirked as a pair of teens came rushing down the small mountain. The ashman waited until they came close enough for him to step in their path. One let out a gasp and quickly jerked the reins in the direction, causing the sled to swerve off course, headed straight for the trunk of a large pine tree. Jump off! Izuku yelled, leaping off and the left of the sled. Wayne followed his actions and landed face first in the snow with a quiet off. Oh no, Wayne! Izuku rushed over to his friend and helped her stand up, brushing snow away from here. Brushing her snow away from her hair and clothes. Before he could get it all off, though, Wayne broke broke free from his hold and jogged over to Katsuki. Scarlet's eyes watched her tauntingly as she approached, and he was positive that he had finally gotten her. Katsuki! His smirk grew. This is it. She is going to release all her anger at me. Blow up, yelling into her lung slash. He stopped in front of him. Oh my god, are you okay? We almost hit you! Katsuki's face fell. What? The hair-colored girl placed her palm on his cheek and pulled him closer, examining his face with worried eyes. His cheeks went pink, and I hated it. I don't see any injuries. Does it hurt anywhere? When asked, Katsuki's flesh gone unnoticed by the oblivious girl. Are you fucking serious? Word jumped slightly at his raised tone, but kept her hold on his face. Katsuki let out a strangled growl and took her wrist, roughly shoving her away. She stumbled backward, but quickly regained her balance. Wen's gaze at the ash blonde with sympathy filled her eyes as he stomped away, kicking up the snow as he went. Something's off? Shoto muttered, looking around the surrounding students. YN followed his blank stare, but found nothing, so she shrugged it off. Why do you say that? She questioned, head tilted to the side slightly. Bakugo. The dual-haired male decided it's because of Bakugo. Wen released an almost silent gasp. You're right! Where is he? I better go find him. I don't want him missing out on our celebration. She ran off before Todoroki could say anything else. He rolled his... My foot is hurting. He rolled his heterochromantic eyes. I meant it was because he isn't trying to terrorize us. But yeah, go find him. Remind him his classmates are having a good time and that he should destroy it. After searching for quite some time, Wen found the ash blonde on the roof of the building, staring out at the surrounding city. She sighed in relief and went to sit next to him. Katsuki noticed her presence, but decided not to acknowledge her. Neither of them said anything for a while. Katsuki? Wen asked quietly, not meeting the angry ash blonde's eyes. What? The teen grumbled in response. Why do you hate Christmas? Katsuki opened his mouth to speak, but nothing left his lips. Wen looked up and looked up and stared at him expectantly. And in that moment, as he stared at the eager hair-colored girl sitting by his side, the tree hit him like a hurricane of bricks. Katsuki didn't hate Christmas. He didn't hate the fact that Wen loved it. He hated not spending the holidays with her. Shit. He said, face going blank. I'm sitting very uncomfortable. What's the matter? She asked, the same concerned look flashing across her feature. He, again, couldn't think of a response. Well, what are you supposed to say? Oh, I'm just coming out of the realization that I've unknowingly fallen for you, and that I'm jealous of literally everyone of your friends because you hang out with them instead of me during Christmas, even though that technically is my fault because I'm the one trying to sort the Christmas spirit and... You can talk to me, you know that. Her voice shook him out of his thoughts, and he shrugged. I don't know. Wen gave him an understanding smile and got her to her feet. That's okay, I'll make you love it, I'm sure. She held out her hand for Katsuki to take, but he simply stared at her offer. Then, with a long moment of hesitation, he placed his palm over hers and hoisted himself up. Baka ended up only inches away from her when he stood up, causing her to rest his face. Why smiled. Come join the party, please. He nodded stiffly, and together they headed back to meet their classmates. Maybe one day he'll be able to confess, tell her the real reason he acted out the way he did. But for now, he figured he'd simply make up for the last time. Oh, that was so cute. I'm sorry if you hear like weird noises when I move. It's my chair. I don't know what's wrong with it. It's like, chair was in my kitchen, but I have like a desk at my, like in my house. So yeah, so that's why I need a chair. But yeah, I think this may be the last video for today. I'm kind of tired today, but I love making videos, so it's alright. But no further ado, I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good night, day, afternoon. Bye!